Hello, campers! Welcome back to camp!
Hello!
Today we're going to be playing XCOM. This is one of my favoritest of favorite games.
It's pretty fucking fun.
I really enjoy the strategy games. For those of you who don't know XCOM, if you know Fire Emblem, it's like a sci-fi version of Fire Emblem. Anyway, for right now we're going to do, we're just starting out, story mode. We gotta pick where our base is. Facekicker, since you're going to be doing most of the choices, go ahead and let me know where you want the base. In North America, aircraft costs 50% less to purchase and maintain. In Europe, laboratories and workshops cost 50% less to build and maintain. In Asia, all projects in the foundry and officer training school are 50% less.
Of course, racist.
They're very good at what they do. It's true. In South America, all interrogations are completed instantly. Because they're very good at interrogating and autopsies.
Yay!
And in Africa, we get extra money. Every month. Nope, nothing racist about that one.
Nope. Let's think.
Asia. Asia for the foundry and the officer training school.
Yes, the area of engagement for this mission will be in India.
All right. Do you want the girls or the guys? Up a local broadcast. Oh, there's alien three girls in a major
metropolitan area. Okay. We should get down there and ugly ass women. Hostiles.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna each control two people. Is how we're gonna be running this.
Okie dokie. Landing.
You wanna tell me? Do you want the guy or do you want two girls?
Strike one.
Stick
this
with the
sexy
guy.
You are free to engage
guys
from all contacts
in the Yay, Canada!
Don't take any chances. Oh, okay. Do you want Sophia?
Zoa.
Juan?
Not Zoa! Zoa!
What are you talking about?
What's her name?
Sophia?
No. Zoa! Oh,
Zoa. Who are they?
Zoa!
Do you want
to be Simeon and Zoa?
You want to be those two?
Yes.
Who's the other last person? Papella?
Papella.
I'll be Papella and Sophia.
Yes.
Wait,
did her name change?
I guess I might as well go first. No. Takia Papella. We're going to be customizing these people to be whatever we want at a later time.
Default characters!
I'm on the move. It just got hot here.
So I'll control my characters first, just because I'm looking at the controller at the moment.
Whoa! They be playing with the We're green goopy goop.
Those are human bodies.
So
what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over into this Overwatch, which for those of you who haven't played the game, it makes it so if an enemy moves within my line of sight, she fires at them.
Yay.
And pretty much you want to do that with all your characters if you don't have a line of sight and if you don't need to reload. I'll leave that one for you, and I guess I'll rush by up here to this full cover. See, the full shields are full cover, so it provides you more protection from enemy bullets. So I'm gonna dash up there. Each character has, like, basically two turns. They have, like, basically their move turn, and then they have an action. With some characters, if you do their action first before their move, they can't move afterwards. It just depends on what kind of character you are. Right now, these are all rookies, so you can go ahead and do in whichever order you want.
There's nowhere really to go.
Well, you can either stay behind a little bit or you can dash
up there.
So kind of the premise for this is that aliens are invading and we're trying to stop their invasion. That's basically the entire storyline.
Pigeons.
There are pigeons. I just got rid of the pigeons. Taking a shot!
At
that box.
Oh god, that box moved!
Why wouldn't you have waited till he, like, got there?
Because the AI isn't always the smartest. Like, the Overwatch AI.
It's very true. Whoa, there's more up there!
They spawn all over the place. They're going into the fog of war where we went to see them.
Maybe that was a bad place for me. Well, I guess it wasn't really bad place for me, though.
In the top left, that's very helpful. That means I can actually see one of them. I can see him right there. But see how he's doing his little glowy thing with his brain? That means his friend is powering him up. And if I kill his friend, it'll actually kill them both. That or it's the other way around. So, I don't know if I want to throw a grenade or shoot. A 40% chance to hit, or I can just deal 3 damage straight off. Probably shoot. Yeah, let's shoot.
Shoot him in the head! Or his stomach.
So I hit him, but I didn't hit him like full on, so it didn't do the full 4 damage. This Papella is still
Papella!
I was trying to hand it off.
Papella! Papella!
If I go here, those other people will be able to shoot me, but that's fine. Because I should be able to just take this guy out. Little problem.
Woohoo!
See you in hell.
Bye-bye.
Now, I don't know if that killed the other one. We're probably going to want to
we should look closely
check that
for
out.
Any fragments that could be salvaged for our own development programs.
Here. And then... Okay, so I still can't see nobody.
You're Canadian.
But there is up here. I know they're up here. There's one up ahead. No, one over here. So...
I really like how the game involves layers into the map. I like how it's introducing them as if for the first time. Nope, didn't kill that one.
Cover my
flank. But now that we know, we can search...
Cool, at least he can't aim.
Also, some weapons can actually destroy environments, which is also a really fun feature. So if you want to shoot a guy and there's a wall in the way, just throw a grenade first, get rid of the wall. Yeah, you're gonna want to get him.
Yeah.
Or put him in a better position, actually.
Watch the flanks! Cover my flanks!
That person's way exposed.
Boom, boom!
So,
their
as you can see, there's the reload mechanic. Down there in the bottom right, you can actually see that my gun is partially empty. The black is the empty, the blue is not empty.
It even tells you how much it uses, too, when you're going to shoot.
Yep. I'm going to throw a grenade, though. Oop! Aha! I can't see. With the grenade, everyone starts with 1 if you have it equipped to them. Which all rooms have it.
You may want to instruct your men to exercise restraint when using explosives.
Oh, that's still me. Also, notice how the person's yelling at us. It's because when we use explosives to kill aliens, it destroys their bodies, which we want to keep so we can do autopsies on them. Which sometimes you don't want to do that because you need to live more than you need to capture dead bodies.
Here. Wait, what? Why did it switch?
I think you dashed.
I did not.
You did.
I was right there. It was in the blue.
Was it?
Yeah.
Try pushing the bumper and see if it changed. It looks like you dashed on accident.
How?
You might have pushed dash without realizing.
Should I grenade him instead?
You could grenade him, and that's a safe option. Because he can kill you in one hit next turn. Or you can overwatch, hope he moves, or you can...
Blow him the fuck up.
Or yes, you can blow him the fuck up.
Blow him the fuck up!
Go Canadian!
Go Canucks! But he didn't blow it up, he's still there. So technically we couldn't autopsy it here.
Oh, it wouldn't be that. Oh yeah, there's a hole there now. You can go inside that if you want to.
Woo!
What kind of shot do I have? 45%?
But you could also shoot you in the ass.
I could also shoot you in the ass. That's tempting.
Don't shoot me in the ass.
I could also go up here. You can try going up here. Since there's nobody over there anymore to hinder me. Also, if you're at an elevation, you actually get a hit bonus. I forgot about that.
Meow, meow, meow! Like, directly to his eyeballs.
Indeed. It's Papella. We'll run over here, which isn't the greatest cover, but I can pretty much kill him right here. Never mind. If 52% chance. Your turn's next, so I just count on you if I miss.
Good work out there, Strike One.
What?
We win.
I thought there was another one up top.
No, you killed it.
No, there was two up top.
No, he jumps down and starts shooting at you. You blew him up. And then the other one jumps down, and that's when we're fighting.
Okay.
That was our first mission, guys.
Yay! Mission.
And these episodes are not going to be just 10 minutes long. Looking at it.
Yes.
We'll do one more mission before we, before we quit. We're not going to be watching any cutscenes if we can help it. Oop, I did that.
Promote.
Sophia, I got a sniper.
But without sufficient
training, and Bumpella they're vulnerable
in
close combat is a support.
Yay.
Just like it sounds, to my favorites. The
support and, class provides that just squads. I'm going to promote him. They make everyone I'm a run and gun.
The assault class serves as our front line. They're the first ones into a fight. Run and gun is that ability. The last ones out.
Sweet. Aw, but I'm wounded for the next 6 and 4 days.
Well, you shouldn't have got shot.
She wasn't a mad choice.
The recovered artifacts are being unloaded, and the research team is waiting your orders.
Alright, now let's go do all this stuff.
We have to talk to everyone.
Commander, I realize our troops have to put
I'm just putting things at the things that it wants us to do.
Okay.
Real fast, just so we can get it over with. We want the medkit anyway. So, and then it wants us to go here, and it wants us to scan for whatever. First, though, we're gonna go to the barracks, view our soldiers.
But I kinda have to get a new person.
I'm gonna take Ricardo. He's gonna be mine.
Ricardo.
And I'm gonna replace him with Bapella, because I don't really want Bapella.
Get out of here, Bapella.
I mean, I like her class. If I could give this class to him, I would. But I want a dude.
A Jew.
There is. It's a lady Jew.
It's a Jew. It's an ugly lady Jew.
You can change what they look like. Like, if you wanted to go in here, you can, like, customize them. Change their names.
Be nice to Simma.
Change their rate. I'm not going to change them. That's for you to do.
But he's wounded, so I can't take him out to battle right now.
Nope. You'll have to do that in 4 days. So I don't want Bapella at all if you want to take over Bapella.
No.
I want my main to be Sophia and Ricardo.
Nope, you can kill her.
Okay. And then we will, we'll be customizing these later, off camera.
Feed her to the slaughter.
So let's just go to mission control. Actually, the entire reason I went into the barracks...
Because you got a new person and you didn't do it.
No, I wanted to customize his loadout and give him the medkit. We can also change their weapons and their sidearms when we get new ones. And their armor is really fun to change because it actually changes how they look, like completely.
Yes,
a lot of fun.
You can actually change.
We're
in, look so funny looking either.
We're on like the Indonesian islands.
But it looks like it's passing time, so I could bring him in.
Ooh, do we want to scramble the interceptors?
Sure.
We were able to pick up a alien spacecraft.
Yay!
And now we gotta go shoot it down.
Cool. I think 4 days passed.
4 days did pass. Actually, more than that, because both your characters
are on the bandit. Oh, I got my car. And I'll probably keep Simone, but I want to keep the rhythm.
With this, we don't actually get to control it.
Woo!
We'll get things later that will allow us to buff them. Should we send a Sky Ranger?
Yes.
This way we get to look at different things and... I don't want that.
I don't want her. I
want Ricardo. And you wanted to change this one?
Sure. I don't want no damn Jew. Let's go with Lucas.
You want Lucas?
Yes.
Two blonde people.
He's German. And he's blonde. He's got. Does he have blue eyes? So then that's the epitome of racism.
I don't know. We can't get that close. Here we can. He does. He's blue eyes.
Ah, racist.
That's cool. Also, we can always make him look like you too.
Do it again.
That's what I was planning to do with Sanchez. Was to make him look like me.
Yeah.
Although I'm just going to keep going through people until I get a male that's a support class because I want to support.
You'll be heading into Japan
as my character.
I want to run and gun.
It looks like the aliens went down.
Or you want the assault class to be yours?
If there are civilians in the area,
so you'll probably want the one you already have in Canada.
Aw, he's a Canuck. We're gonna have the German.
You'll see what the German becomes.
True.
But he might become a heavy because we don't have one yet.
Very true. And if he becomes all heavy, I'll stick with the heavy and the assault.
Because the heavy gets a rocket launcher.
Yes.
In a full
loud and clear, big sky. We'll monitor those
machine gun of some
here.
Sort. So I'm gonna put my sniper up here. Because we want to get her close enough that she'll be able to see everything. And I'm pretty. There's not usually. During these, there's not usually a bunch of enemies really close. So usually it's fine running them up a little bit.
I'ma come next to you.
Okay. We'll be friends.
Lucas is now your friend. And then Simone. Simone, you get this tree.
Moving to designated position.
Why are you kissing the rock?
Because the rock is his favorite.
Alien activity.
How far does the map go in this direction?
That far.
Not very far. Meaning the spaceship is going to be kind of up that way and to the right, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go back. So, Sophia, with the sniper rifle, this is one of those that you cannot shoot after you move. You can switch to your pistol and shoot if you wanted to, but other than that, you're kind of stuck.
Closing on target position now.
Since we still can't really see the... Oh, well, I put her a little farther.
Got aliens!
Because I want her... Again, because I want her close enough to shoot, but not close enough to be shot at quite yet.
Go! Sanchez!
Cool. I have one in my sights. Remember, they could be anywhere over in that direction as well.
Yeah. Here. Go here.
There's probably a dude that can see you there. No. He can move and see you, I bet. But...
And then I'll go here as well. Wait.
Are we splitting up?
Yes.
Okay.
That it probably would be best.
Stepping off.
I'll just keep following the road.
Take the shot!
Yeah. Ouch! He
took out your ear hole.
He shot some, you got a good shot on me. And I think you're, yeah, that guy's completely exposed right
now. At least he missed.
And it still missed. Alright. Shall we... Well, it doesn't really matter if I headshot them, it'll kill them either way. I will shoot that one.
Thanks, Quinn.
And she missed.
No, I don't thank you, friend. I take that back.
Don't worry, she's a beginning sniper. She'll be better. He has the med kit. Which is unfortunate that I can't just throw a grenade at this guy. I want to go up here, but if that guy moves, he'll get a clear shot at me.
But I still can go, and I can get him.
Yeah, I'm going to let you take care of him.
Aye, aye.
And I'll just try to take out this one. Oh, good. Good. Leave him with one health.
Yay!
You're going to die, Sanchez. I had faith in you. Had.
I'll go here. Or should I just shoot?
You could try and shoot if you want to see what kind of numbers you have.
45.
That's about average.
Heading to that location.
Is this your German? Yeah, it is.
See.
Ah. Still 45. Take the shot.
Take shot.
Oh, that's a kill. Whenever it goes to a cinematic, it's a kill.
You're welcome. And then I'll have him.
Right, permanent.
Oh, remember, since he's an assault, he got assigned a shotgun. So remember that.
Okay. So he's a shoddy man.
Also, your ability, run and gun, allows you to shoot after you've dashed. Which is, it basically gives you an extra action. substantial.
They're pulling back.
Oh, they're retreating.
I hope that those are not the only two and staying out of combat. Fire.
No, there's going to be at least four. That is like minimum. There's a couple coming out of the UFO right now.
They're adorable.
So pretty. So now we know where the UFO is. Can you shoot him?
Let's hope.
There we go.
He's down.
I didn't look like you hit it all, but I'll take it. Alright, idiot. Heal yourself.
That's a tree.
Yeah, that is a tree. The tree needs to be healthy.
The tree needs to be healthy for you to be healthy.
The tree actually gives me a regeneration 5. Pretty good if I say so myself.
Let's do this.
So they're over the
I think they were behind it.
Yeah, they went behind.
I don't know why it showed us them, but it did. So
okay.
Sometimes this game's a little bitchy.
Roger that.
Anyway, the reason we were starting to play this is because the new XCOM is going to be coming out in February.
Yes!
And we don't play it.
We might not, we probably won't finish the storyline on the channel here. We're just going to be playing it until the new one comes out, basically. Which hopefully it'll be a lot of fun for both you guys and us.
I have fun with it. I like the game.
The game's good. I'm going to dash forward again.
Target confirmed. On our way.
Don't worry about it.
Okay. Not worrying.
You're closer to the UFO than I am.
Hmm.
Should have followed you, I guess.
Roger, Dodger.
No, we.
Oh, it's go time.
Our readings can't be right.
Watch out for that. Because that thing does a lot of damage.
I got that. Should I run and shotgun him?
You probably should run and shotty.
Like, is it a dash and shotty? Or just run and shotty?
No, run to the edge of the blue.
Like here?
However far you want.
Yeah, I'll do here.
Go.
Yes, Commander.
Then you activate the ability.
Which is...
the run and gun. The yellow one, yeah, that one.
Moving to firing position.
And then move closer, and then watch out though, because those guys can shoot you right after.
Like,
but there's
right
only
here.
One of him.
Like right here?
Sure.
Okay.
And then you go ahead and take the shot. 82% chance. There he goes.
Got him! Got him! If I get shit in the face.
Only 2 damage so far. It's fine. Those things do on average 3. Don't move! That is all that said right there, was don't move. That's an alien door. You can go open it.
Let's go.
It is. That's right. Since they won't be able to shoot me through the door anyway,
solid copy.
I'm gonna run up again.
You just ran through fire.
That's okay. I'm fire retarded.
You're a fire retard?
Yes. That's what I said.
Moving on target location.
Run her up here.
At least she didn't run through the fire.
No, she was smart enough to run. She's not retarded.
So I can see both again.
Use the D-pad to go down. Sometimes the controls do that, and it's kind of annoying.
Okay.
You can go in here behind the console. Just make sure your dash action is not engaged, like it was that one time.
Yeah.
That all you got?
Cool. Cool beans. You have a 50 and a 25.
Tagging the 50.
Sounds good. Awesome.
I missed, but I gotta take
your,
it.
Your grenade probably would probably get both of them if you wanna throw a grenade.
I could run here where
you could run right outside the door. Like right in the corner of the doorway.
Yeah, like right. Yeah?
Or like corner,
yeah.
Yeah. Cause then you can poke your head around. No.
Yeah.
You have to cover, yeah.
That's affirmative.
Whenever you can, you should always get cover. Bad cover is better than no cover. Yeah, looks like you can get both of them with a grenade if you wanted to.
Drag out.
Interesting you would think that door, but okay.
Whew, both.
There was five alien. Oh yeah, because there was the commander. The
commander guy did a shovel in his face.
Yep. We're gonna have to try and capture one of these later, which sucks. What? I'm not spoiling things.
I wouldn't say that spoiling is just the fact that it's gonna suck.
Commander, to the situation room.
Lucas can get promoted. Promoted.
A heavy weapons specialist.
Yay!
He's heavy.
That's a heavy.
With the rocket launcher in tow, there are demolitions experts.
Cool.
Magic. Alright, these are all the things we recovered. We recovered all these things.
Nice.
We can use those for research and stuff.
Every member of the council is going to watch satellite coverage.
We gotta launch a satellite.
Satellite.
Where do we want to put a satellite over? Because if we continue to put satellites over Asia, it'll start boosting the amount of engineers we get per month, which we already get plus two. But at the same time, we can get extras. It also tells us how much money we get up there. We get an extra 100 for China, extra 60 for India and Australia. Well, if we move to, like, Germany, it'll start giving us some extra scientists. North America, scientists and engineers.
There was someone that gave us 180.
Was that USA?
Yes,
it was USA.
Let's go there.
At the same time, though, let me say one more thing. If we get all of them in the same one, like if we get all four of these, it'll give us another bonus.
Future combat! Let's do it.
Emerson,
let's go Asia.
We'll monitor that.
You want to go China just because of the extra money?
Yes. The UFO activity.
Is at maximum capacity. So now the satellite will be up after a certain amount of days, which is nice. We can also visit the gray market and start selling things. Damaged items you can sell for free without any penalty. It says that over there because it gives us no benefit. So might as well sell them. These, though, we don't want to, or we can sell these if we need money. But if we don't need to, I wouldn't suggest it. Because it allows us to build alien weapons and stuff later on.
Which can be helpful against fighting aliens.
It can indeed. Alright, campers, we'll end this episode here. Thank you all so much for watching. If you liked it, please hit that like button. If you want to see more, then you can go to our channel and check out some of our other stuff. But for now, we'll see you around the campfire.
Bye, campers.